dispatched into the beast grave by Nagash himself to collect the long-owed bone tithe of the silent people, Kainan's reapers have found their quarries long fled, but will not return to their master empty-handed. Welcome to this painting video, where we're going to show you how to paint Kainan's reapers, the Ossiarch Bone Reaper warband from Warhammer Underworld's Dire Chasm. We're going to use really easy to follow steps so you can paint along at home and get your warband on the table, earning glory, collecting that bone tithe in no time at all. So grab your paints and your brushes and your Soul Reaper axe, and let's get started. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint Mia Kainan, the monstrous leader of the warband. But of course, many of the techniques I'm going to show you here can be transferred to other members of the warband too. Now, to prepare our model for painting, I've already undercoated it here with Mechanica's standard grey spray, the perfect colour to use for all the paint I'm going to put over the top. The first area of the model I'm going to paint is that fleshy robe that hangs around his waist. I'm doing this first as it's going to be quite a messy part of the miniature. We'll do this and get it out of the way so we can tidy up other areas later on. The first paint I'm using is Rakarth Flesh here, and for this I've got my medium base brush. Let's take some Rakarth Flesh here from the pot and apply it to our palette like so. Now with a base paint like this, I'm going to take a little bit of water from my water pot, mix it into the palette like this, just to help make sure that paint goes on really smooth. Then onto the miniature, here we're applying it all over that fleshy robe that hangs around Mia Kainan's waist like this. Now over a Mechanicus standard grey undercoat like this, it should be nice and easy to get a nice solid base coat. But if you do need a second coat over the top to get a nice solid colour, just apply a second one after the first coat dries. Also, try and be as neat as you possibly can here, but don't worry if you hit other parts of the model, we're going to be painting those later on. There we go, it's taken a couple of coats, but we have a nice solid base coat of Rakarth Flesh all over the robe. Okay, let's finish that robe off next with first a contrast paint. And here I'm using Fire Slayer Flesh, mixed with contrast medium to thin it down. I'll apply it all over the robe, and once that's dry, I'll take Druchy Violet Shade and paint it into the very deep creases where the sheets of flesh meet. Then I'll highlight the robe first with Rakarth Flesh, and then Flayed One Flesh. First of all, it's time for that Fire Slayer Flesh and contrast medium mix. Grab me a medium shade brush for this one. First of all, I'll take one brushful of Fire Slayer Flesh and apply it to my palette here. Then I'll wash the brush off to make sure there's absolutely no paint left on there at all. I don't want to contaminate the medium with any paint. Then I'll take one brushful of contrast medium here and apply it to my palette and mix it in. And this means I'll have a really thinned down Fire Slayer Flesh. I'll load the brush up and now onto the model. Here we're applying it all over this fleshy robe. So a nice even coat all over the place. Just make sure as it's drying, it doesn't pull too heavily in any of the deeper areas, especially down here at the bottom of the robe. We're making sure it's a nice even coat all over like so. If you want a darker flesh look, you can always apply a second coat, as I think I'm going to do here, to give a nice grim dead flesh look. With the contrast paint dry, I've now got Druchy Violet Shade, and with a small layer brush, I'm just going to drop it into all the little folds in between the sheets of flesh here on the robe. If you're going over the edges here, that's absolutely not a problem at all. Gives a nice sort of bruised appearance. With that done, I've now got Rakarth Flesh again. Here I've thinned it down on my palette with a bit of water, and using a medium layer brush, and go around the edges of the fleshy robe like this, giving a bit of a chunky highlight like so. So just nice and neat here around the edges like this, picking out all the raised areas on the flesh cloth. Lastly, on the robes, I've got some Flayed One Flesh. And here again, I've thinned it down and I'm using a small layer brush just to paint the absolute sharpest highlights along the very edges here. I'm also going to use this now to pick out the stitches as well that hold the folds and flaps of flesh together like this. With that highlight applied, that's the fleshy robes complete. Okay, up next, let's have a look at painting the dark brown bone that makes up Kainan's body. And for this, we'll start off with a base coat of Dryad Bark. Once that's applied, we'll then wash those areas with Nuln Oil before layering back over with Dryad Bark again. Then we'll take highlights with Steel Legion Drab, Baneblade Brown, and Karak Stone. First of all, is that base coat of Dryad Bark. And for this, I've got my small base brush. Now here again, let's take some paint from the pot, add it to our palette. Now again, with a base paint like this, add a little bit of water to help thin it down to make sure it goes on super smooth. And then we're painting this all over those areas on Kainan's body that are brown. So we've got the feet, the legs, the arms, the head. Quite a few areas on this model. If you're a bit confused about which parts are brown, have a really good look at the picture on the back of the box. it'll really help you out. Now here I'm using a small base brush for added control, as we're being super careful not to hit the fleshy parts of the model we've already painted. Just take your time here, be as neat as you possibly can. Next up, I'm applying a wash of Nuln oil all over these brown areas here using a medium shade brush, applying quite a thick layer. Next up, it's Dryad Bark again. This time I'm using it as a layer, so I've got a medium layer brush here, which means we're just going around all the brown areas here, picking out the raised areas and leaving the deeper recesses the original colour we've just painted on. Now take your time here, be as neat as you possibly can, so make sure you're just hitting those raised areas like this to get this really cool layered effect. Next up, it's Steel Legion Drab. Here I'm using a small layer brush and I've thinned the paint down quite a bit with water, and now I'm just highlighting the edges of the bone areas like this. So just picking out the raised areas like so, just making sure we're leaving those deeper areas the original colour. Now up here on the face, we'll be doing the same again, but on the face of Kainan, what I want to do here is make the front of the face a little bit lighter than everywhere else. So here on the face, I'm using Steel Legion Drab, almost like a layer. With that done, we're now doing a second highlight, this time with Baneblade Brown. And again, with a small layer brush, I thinned it down quite a bit. And I'm just picking out the absolute edges of all the parts of the bone here. So we're leaving a little bit of that Steel Legion Drab showing through underneath, just picking out the absolute raised parts. Up here on the face, we're painting this as a highlight again, but this time a bit of a thicker highlighter. You want that face to be a bit lighter. So a bit more of Baneblade Brown being used up here, but again, still just picking out those raised parts. Finally, on the bone, we've got a cheeky little bit of Carrot Stone, which we're using just to pick out the absolute raised parts here and here, and also to highlight areas on the face as well. So just work your way around here and find any really high parts on the bone, highlight the face. With that final highlight done, that is the brown bone complete. Okay, up next, let's paint Kainan's eyes. And for this, it's nice and simple. It's a dot of white scar followed by a layer of Hexwraith Flame over the top to give it that weird, eerie green glow. Now, first of all, for that white scar, as it's the smallest detail in the model, I'm going to use my small layer brush. Now, here with the white scar, I'm not going to be using the palette at all, but I'm just going to take the dots of paint on the end of the brush, like so, very carefully, just dotting that paint onto the end of the brush to make sure we keep the tip as well. Then, very quickly, onto Kainan. Here I'm going to brace my hand against the side of the paint handle and apply a nice white dot onto each of the eyes. With the white dot painted in, I've got some Hexwraith Flame. It's a special technical paint which gives a weird green glow. And here I'm going to paint it into the white dot and also into the eye sockets too. Maybe even a little bit around the eye sockets to make it look like his eyes are glowing with dead energy. There we go, that's the eyes done. Okay, up next, let's have a look at painting that famous Ossiarch Bone Reaper purple armour. Now, for this, we're going to start off with a base coat of Abaddon Black all over the armour. Then, we're going to be using Phoenician Purple to highlight it first, followed by Rust Grey, and then Ulthuan Grey over the top of that. First of all, is that base coat of Abaddon Black, and here I've got my small base brush. So let's take some Abaddon Black here from the pot and onto our palette. And as always with the base paint, just a little bit of water helps smooth it down to make sure it goes on nice and thin. Then here we're painting all the segmented parts of the armour all over Kainan. So we've got this up here on his shoulder. We've also got, of course, his breastplate going across here as well. At the same time, we're also going to paint these decorations here as well. These ones hanging down from his chest and also these ones around his waist. We'll come to paint those later on. With the base coat done, we're now going to be taking Phoenician Purple and highlighting the segmented parts of the armour. Now, here we've thinned it down quite a bit, so it goes on nice and subtly. We're using a small layer brush to get nice chunky highlights in on these segmented pieces of the armour. Do your best here to take your time, be as neat as you can. We're just looking to pick out the edges here of each part of the armour, just like this. Next up, we're applying a highlight of Rust Grey over the top, and here we can use the edge of the brush like this just to pick out the absolute edges of these panels. And finally, a touch of Ulthuan Grey is being used on the absolute edges and tips of the armour here to make it really stand out. I'll also use this colour to pick out the rivets on the armour as well. So there we go, that's the Ulthwyn Grey highlight complete. You'll also see here I've thinned down some Ulthwyn Grey and dropped it into where the runes are on the armour. And that's how we can add some Hexwraith Flame now onto those runes, again to give it that weird green eerie glow as we did earlier on with the eyes. Again, grab your small airbrush. Let's take some Hexwraith Flame here from the pot, just a small amount here is all we need. And then onto the model here, we're just dropping that into those runes that we just put the Ulthwyn Grey into, again to make it look weird and glowing. There we go, that's the green glow done. Okay, up next let's have a look at painting the grey bone that we see on the shoulder pad rim and collarbone of Kainan. And for this we'll start off with a base coat of Administratum Grey. Here I'm using my medium layer brush to apply it. Let's grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now this is a layer paint here, so we don't need too much water to thin it down, but I will add just a little bit just to make sure it goes on real smooth. And then onto Kainan. Here we're painting this onto the shoulder pad rim and collarbone. So we've got this section here, all over the shoulder pad rim here, being super careful not to hit other parts of the model we've already painted. We've also got the collarbone that goes right across here. Here we're being super neat, just take your time. So there we go, that's the Administratum Grey base coat applied. Now let's finish off that grey bone with first a mix of Lamian Medium and Agrax Earthshade being washed all over the top. Once we've done that and it's dry, we'll then tidy back up again with Administratum Grey and then highlight with Grey Seer. First of all, it's that mix of Lamian Medium and Agrax Earthshade, and for this I've got my medium shade brush. Now first of all, let's take some Agrax Earthshade here and apply it to our palette like so. Here I'm going to make sure I wash my brush off again to make sure there's absolutely no wash left on there at all. And then I'll take one brushful of Lamian Medium here and apply it like so. We're mixing these two together to get a nice thinned down Agrax Earthshade just like that. Then with the brush loaded up, I'm going to apply this all over the grey bone like so. And as it's going on, you'll see the Lamian Medium has made it quite light to give a nice subtle shade. Make sure it's not pouring too heavily in any of the recesses and allow a good 20 minutes or so for it to fully dry before we move on to the next stage. With the wash dry, now I've got some thinned down Administratum Grey, I've thinned it with a touch of water. I'm just going back over again now, almost like a layer. Here we're just picking out the raised parts here, but leaving the lower areas that brown colour we've just applied. And finally, let's pick out the highlights here with Grey Seer. Here, just applying it onto the absolute very edges of the bone here to make it look nice and highlighted. Here, be as neat as you possibly can. Just try not to hit those other areas you've already painted. There we go, that's the grey bone done. Right, let's move on then. And next up, we're going to be looking at painting the leather. This is going to be the necklace around Kainan's neck and also the straps that hold the decorations onto both the necklace and his waist. And for this, we'll start off with a base coat of Doomball Brown. Once that's done, we'll highlight those areas with Scrag Brown. First of all, Doomball Brown is a base coat. And for this, we've got a small layer brush. Let's take a little bit of Doomball Brown here from the pot. We don't need too much here as it's just a small area on the model. Just a touch there, a little bit of water here to thin it down, as always. There we go. And then we're just going to be painting this onto the areas we mentioned. So we've got the necklace around his neck here to the top of the model, like so, just painting it carefully around the top like this. We're also picking out those little straps that hold these decorations onto the necklace. And we'll be doing the same again down here with all the little straps that hold those decorations onto his waist as well. Then over the top of this, it's Scrag Brown here being used as a highlight. I'm just picking out the raised areas like the ringlets like so, and parts of the necklace too, just leaving a little bit of that Doomball Brown underneath. There we go, that's the leather done. Okay, up next let's paint those black decorative pieces hanging around Kainan's neck and around his waist. And for this we'll start off with a base coat of Abaddon Black. Once that's done, we'll then highlight first with Eshin Grey, followed by Dawnstone. For all of these, I'll be using my small layer brush. Let's start with some Abaddon Black here and apply it to my palette. Now here I'm just using a little bit, again, as these areas aren't too big. A little bit of water here will help thin that paint down. And then onto Kainan. Here we're applying this onto these decorations, both around the neck and around the waist as well. Just be nice and careful here and just tidy up all those areas. Make sure any paint you've hit accidentally here is just covered up by this Abaddon Black. And be super careful not to hit other areas too. Next up, it's Eshin Grey. Here, we're using this as a highlight over the top of the black here, just picking out those sharp raised areas. Then, with a touch of Dawnstone on the edge of the brush here, we're just going to pick out a few cheeky highlights like this. Just use the edge of the brush to pick out the absolute tips like so, Just get a few nice sharp highlights. There we go, that's those black decorations done. All right, up next, let's have a look at painting the bright bone on the weapon haft of his giant Soul Reaper axe. Now, for this, we'll start off with a base coat of Wraith Bone. Once we've got a nice solid colour of that, I'll then drop some Hex Wraith Flame into the runes to make them glow before highlighting with White Scar. First of all, Wraith Bone, and for this, I've got my medium layer brush. Again, let's take some Wraith Bone from the pot and onto our palette here. Nice little bit of water will also help thin that down to make sure it goes on real smooth, just the way I like it. Then onto the model, and here we're applying this Wraith Bone all over the weapon haft here. So just being really careful at this point, not to any parts of the model behind the axe. Just making sure we're just hitting the axe haft and nothing else. Now we've got our Hex Wraith Flame out again, and here we're just dropping it into the runes along the axe haft like so. Now, be as neat as you can here, but don't worry too much if you go over the edges. You can always go back with your pot of Wraith Bone and just tidy up. Then, very carefully with some White Scar, we're just going to be picking out the edges around the runes like this, just to make them look like they're a bit brighter. There we go. Be super careful here. Don't worry if you do make a mistake, you can always go back with the Wraith Bone and tidy up again. There we go, that's the haft of the axe done. Alright, up next let's have a look at painting the grey bone, which is on the pommel and head of the axe. Now here we'll start off with a base coat of Grey Seer. Once that's done, I'll apply contrast paint over the top, this time Griffcharger Grey. Once that's dry, I'll then layer back up again with Grey Seer and highlight with Ulthwyn Grey. Once all that is done, I'll take a little bit of Agrax Earthshade and pick out the small brown plate in the centre of the axe head. Now first of all, it's that base coat of Grey Seer, and for this I've got my small base brush. Here we go, let's take some Grey Seer from the pot. You know the score by now. A little bit of water on the palette here helps thin it down. There we go, then onto the model, and here we're applying it onto the areas I just mentioned. So we've got the head of the axe here, all the detail at the top here. Again, being careful not to hit the haft or any other part of the model we've already painted. And also the pommel of the axe down here as well. Then over the top of this, it's Griffcharger Grey contrast paint. Here we're applying it quite liberally, but do make sure it's going on nice and smooth. Don't allow it to pull too much in any of the recesses. Make sure you're getting a nice even coat all over, like so. Next up, I've got some Grey Seer again. Here I thinned it down with a touch of water. I'm just tidying up those areas I hit with the contrast paint here. Just give a nice solid colour in the areas we want it, like so. Next up, it's Ulthwyn Grey, and here I'm using it on the very edges here just to pick out the highlights like so, and if you can, use the edge of the brush like this to get a nice sharp highlight. Next up, I've got some Agrax Earthshade. Here I've mixed it with a touch of water. I'm just applying it into the centre of the axe head here to help break out the colours. There we go, that's the bone part of the axe done. Okay, up next, let's have a look at painting the small amount of gold on the model, and here we're going to be using a base coat of Retributor Armour, followed by a highlight of Stormhost Silver. Very simple. For this, grab your small layer brush. Let's take some Retributor Armour here from the pot, and onto the palette here. We're not going to thin this down, as we're only using a really small amount of paint. That's all we need. Then onto Kainan. Here, the small bit of gold in question is this gold circlet here on the end of the axe head, so we're just going to just paint this in here like so. If you hit the axe blade or the jewel right now, that's not a problem. We're going to paint those in a second. There we go. Then over the top of this, it's a highlight of Stormhost Silver. Just a very quick highlight here, just around the edges, like so. There we go, that's the gold done. Nice and easy. Okay, up next, let's have a look at painting that big blade on his Soul Reaper axe. Now for this we'll start off with a base coat of Incubi Darkness. Once that's on, I'll wash over the top with Nuln Oil. Then we'll start layering back up again with Incubi Darkness and Cabalite Green before highlighting with Cyberite Green and finally Gorse Blaster Green. First of all, it's that base coat of Incubi Darkness. Here I've got my small base brush again. Let's take some paint here from the pot and onto our palette. Now here, we want this to go on really smooth, so I'm going to be thinning this down quite a bit with water. That might mean I need to go a couple of layers to get a nice solid base coat, but that's not a problem at all. So here we go, over the top like so, a nice coat of Incubi Darkness all over the blade like this. We're also going to paint that jewel inside the circlet at the same time, but on the blade make sure you get a nice solid and smooth base coat. Then, over the top of the base coat, it's a wash of Nuln oil all over the blade like this. Now, just make sure as it's going on, it doesn't pull too heavily in any areas. We're looking for a nice smooth coat here that darkens down the whole blade. Once the wash is dry, I've now got Inky by Darkness again, and here I've thinned it down quite heavily with water. I'm applying it over the top of the blade here towards the sharper points of the edges, like so, and at the bottom here as well. Now, when this is dry, it'll go on really subtle, so you can afford to have a nice, thick layer like this, leaving quite a little bit of the black towards the inside of the blade. Then, after this, it's Cabalite Green, again here being painted towards the edges of the blade like this, just working our way around like so. Maybe a slightly thinner layer just going inside the one before, and again, like the Inky by Darkness before it, I thinned it down quite a bit with water just to make sure it goes on nice and subtly. Now, Cyberite Green is being used on the very edges here. We can use the edge of the brush like this just to get a nice sharp highlight of Cyberite Green. Again, we thinned it down to make sure it goes on nice and subtle and clean like this. Just take your time, work your way around the axe. Finally, Gorse Blaster Green, here being used on the absolute sharpest tips of the axe blade here. So just near the edge like so, and also down here, the sharp points at the bottom too. There we go, that's the axe blade done, and we've used the same colour to paint the small jewel in the centre of the blade as well. With that done, it's time to move on to painting Mir Kainan's base. Now here we're going to start off by base coating the entire base with Eshin Grey. Then we'll pick out the stonework with Storm Vermin Fur, and then we're going to paint all over with Agrax Earthshade. First of all, that base coat of Eshin Grey. For this, I've got my medium base brush. Let's grab some Eshin Grey here from the pot. We need quite a bit of this from the base. So let's take a bit here and then thin it down again to make sure it goes on nice and smoothly. Then onto the top of the base. Here I'm applying a nice even base coat of Eshin Grey all over the top of the base like this. At this point, you'll probably hit the sword and the skull. Don't worry about that. That's not a problem. We're going to go back and paint those later on. Just make sure you're not hitting Mir Kainan's feet or the flesh cloak he's wearing as well. There we go. Now I'm using Storm Vermin Fur to pick out the stonework on the base. Then I'm applying a wash of Agrax Earthshade all over the base, hitting both the stone areas and the sandy bits too. There we go, the wash has dried, giving this really cool, grimy appearance. But let's finish off those areas of the base now with a few dry brushes. Now, first of all, I'm going to dry brush the sandy areas of the base with first Eshin Grey and then Dawnstone. Then I'll dry brush the stony areas with Storm Vermin Fur before using Administratum Grey over the entire base to help bring those colours together. First of all is that Eshin Grey, and for this I've got my small dry brush. Let's take some paint here from the pot and apply it to a piece of tissue paper I've got ready to go. Now with dry brushing, what we're looking to do here is get rid of almost all the paint from the brush, so we're working those bristles into the tissue paper like so. Perfect. Then once that's done, onto the model. Here we're applying back and forth motions over the top of the sandy areas on the base, and you'll see it starts picking out the raised areas like this. It's quite subtle to start with, but you can add more pressure and more passes as you go, and it'll pick up that detail nicely like this. Do this all over the sandy areas and we'll move on to the next stage. Then it's a dry brush of Dawnstone over those areas again. You can see here as we're working over, that colour is picking up those raised areas perfectly. Then we're doing the same again, this time with Storm Vermin Fur, but this time painting it over the stone areas of the base. Here, just taking our time. Now, as you get onto the model here, just make sure you're not hitting the flesh cloak. Just being really careful, just hit the stone areas. And then it's a nice light dry brush of Administratum Grey, here being used over both the stone areas and the sand areas to help highlight both areas and also bring the colours together. There we go, that's the dry brushing done. Now, there's a couple of little details on the base which we're going to paint now. First of all, a skull, which we're going to base coat with Steel Legion Drab, then layer with Baneblade Brown, and then finally highlight with Carrick Stone. First of all, Steel Legion Drab. For this, I've got my small base brush. Let's take a cheeky amount of paint from the pot here. Not too much again. It's only a small area, this. A little bit of water just to help smooth it in. And then, nice and easily, just base coat this onto the skull on the base like so. But of course, being careful not to hit the areas we've already dry brushed before. Then it's a layer of Baneblade Brown. Here we're picking out the raised areas, just leaving those deeper recesses the Steel Legion drab colour. Then finally on the skull, just a cheeky little highlight with Karak Stone. Just picking out the raised parts like the bridges of the eyes and the nose. Just a nice, quick, easy highlight like that. There we go, that's the skull done, nice and easy. But now let's pick out that sword on the base. And to make sure I'm using paints we've already used in this painting guide, I'm going to paint it as a rusty old sword that's been abandoned on the ground. For this, we'll start off with a base coat of Doomball Brown all over the sword, and then we'll dry brush Scrag Brown on top. Then we'll use Stormhost Silver to pick out the edges to make it look like it's really been chipped and battered. First of all, that base coat of Doomball Brown, and for this I've got my small airbrush. Let's take just a tiny amount of paint here from the pot and onto the palette. A little bit of water as always, and then once that's done, we're just going to be painting the entire sword here on the base, all of it, with Doomball Brown. Now I'm dry brushing the whole sword with Scrag Brown, and as it's quite a small area and a bit more control, instead of a dry brush here I'm actually using a medium base brush instead. Just be really careful here not to hit outside the sword. Then finally on the sword, I'm just going to be going around the edges with Stormhost Silver, just chipping it like this to make it look like it's beaten and weather battered. Once I've done this all over the blade of the sword and around the other areas as well, I'm going to paint the rim of the base with Abaddon Black. There we go, with the sword done and the rim painted, the base is complete. And there we go, with that done, Mir Kainan is complete and ready to lead his warband into battle. Don't forget you can use these same techniques to paint the rest of Kainan's Reapers. So there's a couple of things to remember when painting this miniature. First of all, Mir Kainan is the centrepiece of your warband, so it's really worth spending the time to be as neat as you possibly can to make him look super impressive. Second of all, think about the order you're painting things in. In this video, we painted the fleshy cloak around his waist first of all, as we knew it was going to be quite a messy part of the miniature. We got that out of the way, and then we could paint other areas over the top. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Happy painting!